the fall of 1944, near the town of Margraten, a small village of 1,500 people, the Graves Registration Service converted a fruit tree orchard into the U.S. Military Cemetery Margraten, which would later become the Netherlands American Cemetery. Hoping to outflank the Siegfried Line, 390 miles of bunkers, fortifications, and tank traps that defended the German border, the Allies focused on a narrow front in the Netherlands. Operation Market Garden was a bold airborne and ground attack to seize 9 key bridges and secure a route into northern Germany. Ambitious.
John Colson Webb was my father's oldest brother. When Uncle Jack was 18, he enlisted into the Army and volunteered to be a paratrooper. He was accepted into the 101st Airborne, 501st Parachute Infantry Regiment, PIR. During Operation Market Garden, when parachuting into the Netherlands, he sustained multiple injuries from shrapnel. He died 3 days later in a field hospital on September 20th, 1944. He was buried in a temporary grave. After the war was over, families were given the option to have their fallen soldier returned to the United States or buried in a permanent cemetery. In a letter to the War Department, Jack's father, Colson, requested he be buried in a military cemetery where he is with his comrades. May God bless them. In June of 1948, Jack was exhumed wearing his uniform wrapped in a parachute and placed in a transfer box. In September, he was placed in a casket, and in December, reinterred and buried. In March 1949, a letter was sent to Colson informing him Jack had been interred with military funeral and services were conducted at the Margraten U.S. Military Cemetery.
Citizens of Margraten for help. The local population turned out in force, digging enough graves in just 2 days to lay the casualties to rest. Americans who had fallen and been temporarily buried in Germany were reinterred to friendly soil in cemeteries like Margraten. After the war, many of these soldiers' remains were repatriated to cemeteries in the U.S., while other families chose to lay their loved ones to rest in the lands they helped liberate. The American Battle Monuments Commission renders perpetual care for the over 10,000 Americans honored at the Netherlands American Cemetery, ensuring that time will not dim the glory of their deeds. Every name inscribed on the wall of the missing, every name engraved into the thousands of headstones, represents an immeasurable personal sacrifice. But together, these fallen American heroes remind us of our dedication to freedom and the profound strength of unity. Thank you.
The citizens of the Netherlands are very grateful for their liberators. There are two organizations connected to the cemetery that show their appreciation. The Faces of Margraten is a project to collect and locate a photo of each soldier buried or listed on the Wall of Missing. The photos are placed biannually on the Dutch Remembrance Day, giving a face to the name of their liberators. Over 3,300 photos have been collected. The Foundation for Adopting Graves offers the opportunity for the citizens to adopt a grave. These citizens then visit the graves, place flowers, and continue to honor and remember their liberators. All 8,301 graves and 1,300 names on the Wall of Missing have been adopted, and there are over 1,000 people on the waiting list to become adopters. A few years ago, we were contacted to provide a photo of Uncle Jack. We didn't have one. My cousins didn't have one. But they went on an extensive search, and a photo of Uncle Jack was discovered. This was our first opportunity to meet Uncle Jack. The foundation connected with the adopters offered to connect us with a woman who has been visiting Uncle Jack's grave for nearly 20 years. We were so honored to meet her. Learning more about Uncle Jack has brought a deep sense of pride and honor. Learning about him, his service, and knowing he continues to be recognized for his bravery, service, and sacrifice. His story is just one of over 10,000 of the soldiers that are honored and remembered in the Netherlands American Cemetery.